It's a little bit death theme, so I'm going to try and keep it as relaxing as possible, given the topic. And let's get started. So this is the case of Bernard Oliver, who disappeared on January 6, 1967. Muswell Hill in North London, England. Bernard was 17 years old at the time of his disappearance, and he was described as being a quiet, down-to-earth young man. He had no real problems, he was quite a happy teenager, and they also mentioned that he was quite fond of his two small pets. He had a canary and a dog. Bernard met with a young female friend of his for coffee. They met at a cafe in Wood Green, which is very close to his home address. She mentioned that he was very quiet all evening, and at around 8:30 p.m. he kind of suddenly said, I'm going to see a friend. Bernard was not seen alive since by anybody who knew him. There were some sightings, but nobody's sure of how legitimate those sightings were. Bernard's dad raised the alarm when Bernard did not come home the following morning, so this then launched a huge police investigation into his disappearance. Of what the investigation consisted of. However, we do know that his body was discovered 10 days later by a farm worker named Fred Burkey in a field 77 miles away from his hometown. Where was that? I'm just trying to find the location. The location was Tattingstone in Suffolk. Without going into too much detail, the police confirmed that Bernard had been assaulted, strangled, and dismembered, and his body was actually found split between two suitcases and hidden beneath a hedge in a field. Because obviously the body was found 77 miles away from where Bernard lived and was last seen, the police were not able to identify him. So suitcases to, I don't know, whatever they needed suitcases for, relocate, I don't know. But a couple of men confirmed that they had suitcases that looked exactly the same that were given to them, and they were in the military, so vague, but this is what we have. And the case was actually opened multiple times, so the first time it was then opened again, I believe, in 2002. I didn't write this down, I should have. And then it was opened again in 2017. However, nobody really has come forward. No new evidence has come to light, and it remains an unsolved case. And so in terms of witnesses, of the people. Suicide note addressed to the other man. It's just that.